Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Josh Floyd Show. I'm your host, Eric Vaughan, and we're here with the head coach of the Shiloh Saints, Josh Floyd, and we're talking about the 5A West Conference Championship that the Shiloh Saints played for this Friday night. Unfortunately, it didn't go the Saints' way as they lost 37-14 to the Alma Airedales. But the good news is the Shiloh Saints are headed to the playoffs, and we're going to talk about that with the head coach of the Shiloh Saints. Let's introduce to the show now Josh Floyd. Welcome to the show, Coach.
Thank you.
Hey, thanks for being here. And of course, Friday night was a big game. A big game for the 5A West Conference Championship. Would have been a share of it with Morrilton and Alma and Shiloh playing there. But Coach, it didn't go our way. And unfortunately, there were a lot of things that were stacked up against us. But we played without Daniel Shimmer, without Kyle Plunkett, without Chandler Smith. And that's a lot of offense right there. Then we played a very sloppy field, one that was surprisingly wet down there at Alma. Let us know kind of from your perspective how the game kind of got started and all the loss of that talent. What does that say for Shiloh?
Sure. Well, obviously we went into a little bit shorthanded. Those guys are really good football players, and unfortunately it seems to keep building each week. You know, it started out with Kyle got hurt back in the Morrilton game, mm-hmm. and we were hoping he'd get back this week. He's still kind of week to week, depending on how his knee heals up. And then obviously we lost Daniel a few weeks ago, and then unfortunately Chandler Smith's injury ended up being worse than we were hoping for, and so he's going to be out now. But we still have to have guys step up and in those roles, and we did in some ways. We just played a really bad game, and give Alma credit, they played well and they've got a good football team. But I definitely wish we could have that one back, because we did a lot. We played very, very sloppy. The field was in pretty bad shape. You're playing in a lot of mud, and so you've got to learn to adjust to that, and that's the first time we really played in that kind of environment. But we've got to do a better job adjusting to that, and we put the ball on the ground a lot. We were fumbling the ball around, but we had some turnovers, one of those, chalk it up to a bad game. It was a bad night and bad timing for a bad game, but I don't think we've played a bad game all year. I think we've had a couple games where we had bad halves. But that was really the first game I felt like we just didn't play a good game at all. And it's unfortunate that we didn't get it done.
Well, things were pretty tough all the way to the fourth quarter. We're going to get to take a look at some of those highlights. The fourth quarter started to kind of go in Shiloh's way a little bit. We talked about the loss of Shimmer and Plunkett and Chandler Smith, and certainly that's a lot of talent and a lot of offense. But in comparison, Dylan Sharp and the guys that have really stepped up, like Chris Cox, the offensive line, the defense have been playing really well. The last couple of games until Alma, statistically, were equal with, if not just slightly better, than the previous games with those players. So we can't go back and say, well, it was all because we lost those guys, because the talent level's still there and they're still doing well. So lots of credit to Dylan Sharp and Chris Cox, offensive line, defensive line. Yeah. But as we look at the playoffs, going into the playoffs, there's certainly some things that you can build on off of that fourth quarter. Let's talk about the game itself a little bit, and then we're going to go into some highlights. The game itself, preparation leading into a 5A West Conference, what would it have meant for you and the coaches and the kids to come out with a share of that conference championship?
Well, it would have definitely been a nice accomplishment for our team, because it's definitely one of our goals going into the season, it's the same thing every single year, no matter what class you're in or what conference you're in, you want a chance to win a conference title, and it usually puts you in a good position as you can be in for the playoffs. Unfortunately, we just didn't get it done Friday night. It would have been a good accomplishment, because it's one of those, we're only here for 2 years in the conference and we're going back to 4A, so we don't really get many chances. But that being said, I think our guys have had a really good year. I'm really proud of our seniors. The way that they've stepped up, and like I said, we fought through a ton of adversity these last 4 or 5 weeks that none of us would have wanted to go through, and none of us were prepared for totally. And so we're just having to fight, scratch and claw for everything that we get. And we had a couple more guys go down during the game. And those are even worse, those injuries that happen during the game, because then you're replacing people right in the middle of the ball game, and that makes it even tougher. But I'll say this about Friday night: the effort was never an issue. Our guys, they played their tails off, played physical football, and played as hard as we could. We just, for whatever reason, we obviously are checking ourselves as coaches, and obviously I didn't do a good enough job getting our guys ready, because we made so many mistakes that we haven't made all year. So I wish I had the exact answer for that. But hey, well, once again, we're going to chalk it up. It was a bad night for us, and you know, we've got to turn around, forget that, and move on.
Well, before we take our break, something I don't want to be lost on the fans, Coach, is the fact that you guys did move up into 5A West, your second year, and this is a tough conference. 5A is tough in
Good
itself.
Mm-hmm.
5A West is a tough conference, and yet in 2 years, you guys were battling for the conference championship. That is quite an accomplishment, and I want our fans to not be lost on that fact. That is a big victory for the Shiloh Saints that they were even in it, playing for a conference championship. There are many teams that spend decades wanting a conference championship and being denied. And this year it was Alma's turn. You know, it's been a decade or so since they had won a championship. Congratulations to them on their 5A West championship this year. We're going to take a break, and we'll be back with first half highlights of that game when we come back. We want to say thank you to our championship sponsor, Carpet One. For all your carpet needs, go down and see the guys at Carpet One.
It's Carpet One's 25th anniversary sale, and we're celebrating by giving you amazing savings. Take up to 50% off all flooring store-wide. Carpet, hardwood, laminate, tile, vinyl, and more. Buy it all with no interest for 3 years. Plus, get up to $500 cash back with manufacturer's instant rebates. Thank you, Northwest Arkansas, for allowing us to serve you for the last 25 years. Come celebrate and save now during Carpet One's 25th anniversary sale.
I'm Ronnie Floyd of Cross Church, and I want to personally invite you to join us this Sunday. At our church, we believe God's Word changes lives. You see, we believe that when you come to our church, you will find love and community. And we believe that you will find a fellowship that is exciting, but yet compassionate. We hope that you will visit at crosschurch.com and discover a Cross Church campus near you.
You know, it's time here at Cross Church for a new vision.
I'm calling you today to become a part of the Cross Church Circle.
What does this Cross Church Circle do? The Cross Church Circle prays for Cross Church continually.
And we need to be persistent. We need to persistently approach the Father in prayer. How can I not pray when I see the condition of His people? I'm calling you to join me. Only 120 were at Pentecost, and the world has never been the same. Oh, let me tell you today, this is why I'm asking hundreds and even thousands of people on all of our Cross Church campuses today to formulate an army of warriors of prayer. And I'm going to ask you today to become a part of the Cross Church Circle, because the times are desperate, and we, the church, must rise until the church becomes a testimony.
Welcome back to the show, everyone, where we're going to look at some first half highlights of the 5A West conference game between Shiloh and Alma this past Friday night. As we said, it was for a conference championship. Unfortunately, things didn't go Shiloh's way, but we're going to look at these first half highlights and see how the Shiloh Saints fared. Coach, walk us through these first half highlights.
See, Ryan McDonald, Nick Gookin. You know, I really felt like our defense most of the night played well enough to win. There are definitely some plays I'd like to have back. So fourth down, play right here. Great job by Matt Hansen. They couldn't handle Matt Hansen all night. He made a lot of plays. A little draw here with Chris Cox. Our biggest problem offensively the other night was we'd have a positive play and then we'd come back with a negative play. Just, you know, there wasn't any consistency there. So we've got to do a better job there. We had a penalty right there. We had a ton of penalties on us the first half. Started a lot in second and 20, first and 20. And that's tough no matter where you're at, but especially where we're at in our season and those kind of conditions, it's tough. You know, so they got us on a pretty good play action pass there. We had attempted something right there. We had a reverse going for and had some guys mess up and run into each other, and they come back and answer right there. So good play by Alma right there. At this point, they're up 14-0, you know, and you know, one thing we talked about to our kids Saturday was, as horrible as we played, we still had a chance to win the game at the end. You know, we played really, really poorly. And, you know, you got to be careful when you're used to winning a lot to, you know, like this, a lot of these guys are. Just because you're down 14-0 isn't the end of the world. And so, you know, but I feel like our guys – still right here right before half. I think it would have been key if we could have gotten a touchdown right before half, but we just couldn't quite stick it in right there. Once again, had another penalty that backed us up again and just put us in a tough spot.
And you could tell from, if you look at the jerseys of our players, a lot of them used to be white. Now they're black, because they're playing between the 30s here in this first half.
Yeah.
And, between the 30s and between the hash marks, that's where it was at its sloppiest.
Yeah, it's pretty bad.
And we always kind of felt like from the booth perspective, man, if they could just get past the 30 into the red zone, we might have some success because it's a little drier down there. But talk to us a little bit about field conditions. And, of course, both teams playing on the same field,
Yeah, sure.
But it just seemed like what you mentioned a moment ago was very accurate. A lot of slipping, a lot of slippery balls that were falling out of the hands and onto the ground. We were having to sit on the ball, recover fumbles, things like that were setting us back. How do the kids deal with that kind of field conditions?
Well, obviously we didn't deal with it very well Friday night. And, maybe if we get ourselves in that position again, we'll do a better job. I think some of it's it's a mental deal. I really do. I think some of it's just, hey, we got to get over that and rise above that. And then some of it's a legitimate issue because you can't, it's harder to get pushed on the offensive line. It's harder to move people, because your feet are in the ground and with your route running and all those kind of things. It just depends, we've hopefully we've overcome that if we get in a situation like that again.
Coach, are there equipment adjustments that players make? Like I noticed on the first play, Matthew Solomon was on that play end around. The ball slipped out of his hands. Immediately ripped off his gloves, threw him out to the side. He was going to play with dry hands from that point forward. Are there any other adjustments that players can make? Can they get deeper cleats or, different equipment on field conditions like that?
Well, I think some people do that with cleats, but most of the time it's just the same. Like I said, we just got to get better at adjusting to that, I think we could have done better. It's a legitimate problem there for a quarter or so, but I think once you get into it, we just need to learn to adjust better. As far as the gloves go, that does happen where, they're so muddy where it's pointless to wear gloves anymore, So I think our guys play, once again, they played hard. We just didn't play good football, good smart football like we have all season, and that's what you get.
Well, when we come back and take a look at the second half highlights, things get going a little bit better for the Saints as we leak into the fourth quarter. And the fourth quarter is where coach can look at and the team can look at and take some real positives out of this game as they head into the playoffs. When we come back after this break, we're going to look at those second half highlights. But we want you to think about Carpet One as they sponsor this coach's show and others like Shiloh Christian.
It's Carpet One's 25th anniversary sale, and we're celebrating by giving you amazing savings. Take up to 50% off all flooring store-wide. Carpet, hardwood, laminate, tile, vinyl, and more. Buy it all with no interest for 3 years. Plus, get up to $500 cash back with manufacturer's instant rebates. Thank you, Northwest Arkansas, for allowing us to serve you for the last 25 years. Come celebrate and save now during Carpet One's 25th anniversary sale. A tradition of excellence. The birthplace of next generation leaders. Leaders who engage their world and change it one step at a time. This is Northwest Arkansas's Shiloh Christian School.
Welcome back to the show, everyone, where we're going to talk through the second half highlights of the game this past Friday night against the Alma Airedales, the eventual conference champions there. And first one for them in a while. We're glad that they were able to pick up that championship. Now, we come into the playoffs with the third seed, and we're going to talk a little bit about that. Why don't you walk us through these second half highlights, though, Coach?
Sure. Matt Hansen, again on defense. I think you can call his name out a lot. You see Lakin Hall in there. And I think we had made some really good plays on defense.
Yeah.
Had Ben Burke, Alan King, those guys, I think they stepped up and played really well, gave us a chance to win there. Here's a big play. This is one of the biggest plays of the game right here. We get a sack right there. Alan King knocks it loose. Should have been a fumble return for a touchdown. The white hat, he ran down there and gave us a touchdown. Ended up being another guy. Said it was an incomplete pass, so just one of those tough breaks you get on the road sometimes. Good run by Chris Cox. The previous play, the biggest thing about that is that'd been such a big momentum shift, in the game right there. Here's a you know, probably really bad play call by us, really. Not a very good job. You know, it's not really our kids' fault right there. So they get the safety and come back here. And great job by Reed Lowe with the pass, batting that down right there.
Yeah, I thought Reed Lowe had a couple of great pass defenses this past week.
Yeah, he did. You know, right here, not a very good job defensively. You know, we're getting kind of sloppy at this point, and, you know, it's kind of disappointing the way we tackled right there. But our guys, you know, they kept fighting right here, and Matthew Salm has a pretty good return right here that gives us some good field position and gives us a chance to go down and score.
This right here is one of those, the catch goes or the tie goes to the receiver. Reed Lowe did a great job of hanging on to that football.
Oh, yeah, it was a great job by Reed. You know, it was the right call by the official right there because it always goes the offense. And just a good job by Reed in making a play. Chris Cox right there, you know, he's running hard. Unfortunately, with the ball loose, we've got a little bit of fortune right there. Alan King is the one that jumped on right there. And tried to come back and get this two-point conversion at this point in the game. We really need to go for two. And so, good play right there by our quarterback and receiver. Here's Dylan right here. Does a good job. He don't do a very good job up front right there. And Dylan makes a play. You know, really pretty risky, obviously, right there in the end zone. But we didn't have a choice at this point.
Here's a big run, a 69-yard rip by Chris Cox.
Yeah, great job by Chris. That's his third game in a row, I think, he's had a run over 60 yards. And so, good job up front. And, you know, you're looking here, it's down to a two-score game. You know, it's 30-14, and we had a chance and got with that. You know, we had an onside kick, thought we got it, and then they ruled that, you know, they had a rule there that we didn't get the ball. And so, unfortunately, they went down there and ended up getting the ball back. So, good return again by Matthew Solomon right there.
Couple things, Coach, that just for clarification for the fans that were watching on Friday night, that even I, from the booth perspective, wasn't sure about. Now, obviously, there were two big momentum shift changers there in the game. One of those we just saw on the highlights, where there was the fumble recovery for the touchdown. Mm-hmm. The referee with the white hat, he's the man that's supposed to be in charge. And he goes down the field, calls a touchdown, allows a conversation to happen. He's convinced by another official that the arm was moving forward for a forward pass. Therefore, you know, it's obviously a illegal pass, loss of down, all right. Of that. And that's a momentum changer.
Sure.
Because we could have scored. Then, on the ensuing onside kick for Shiloh, it seems like it goes 10 yards. We fall on it. The back judge, who from the booth's perspective probably has the worst viewpoint, the white hat, again, from the front view, calls it the onside kick. It's successful. Shiloh's ball, again, conversation ensues. The white hat is convinced that the other official is the right call. Again, illegal touching, a big momentum shift changer for the Shiloh Saints. And then there's one more call, and that is when Shiloh was sacked and Alma received the safety. On the ensuing kick, the ball goes out of bounds. Flags thrown, you know. We thought from the booth's perspective that goes to the 35-yard line instead, and it must be a rule that we just don't know, but the referee said it is 25 yards from the spot of the kick, which gave Alma incredible field position.
Right, right.
When you go through those momentum shift changers, from your perspective as a coach and the players, how difficult is it to feel like, hey, we're not only fighting bad turf conditions, a great football team, but it kind of seems like every call's going against us.
Well, I mean, it's tough. You know, it's an emotional game, this game is. And I think that's why it's such a valuable game for kids, and it teaches them how to, you know, how things go in real life one day. You know, sometimes you get the break, sometimes you don't. And, you know, there are a couple of things Friday night that, you know, whatever you want to call them, I mean, it was tough situations for us because we were pretty confident. We had a touchdown, and our whole our side of the stadium is going crazy, and we needed that. You know, at that point in the game, we hadn't scored yet, so that would have been a huge momentum swing, and it was a big hit by our kid, and so, you know, that would have obviously been a big boost for us. You know, it's an emotional game, and the key is just having to keep those emotions in check, and you know, you can get mad about it, but you better not let it affect your play. You know, you can get mad about it. You know, I tell our kids, you can get upset about stuff, but, you know, use it to a positive, you know, and go make another play. And so, you know, we were fighting a lot on Friday night. And once again, at the end of the day, we know that we can play a lot better than we just played. And so we're not going to play that again. We won't play that bad again this Friday. I mean, I know our guys are going to be ready and play well.
Well, speaking of this Friday, when we come back from the break, we're going to talk about our 3 seed moving into the playoff system here for the 5A conference. We'll be playing Wynne, who is the number 2 seed, and we'll be at Wynne this Friday night. When we come back from the break, we're going to talk more about that game coming up. We'll see you when we get back after these messages.
You know, it's time here at Cross Church for a new vision.
I'm calling you today to become a part of the Cross Church Circle.
What does this Cross Church Circle do? The Cross Church Circle prays for Cross Church continually.
And we need to be persistent. We need to persistently approach the Father in prayer. How can I not pray when I see the condition of His people? I'm calling you to join me. Only 120 were at Pentecost, and the world has never been the same. Oh, let me tell you today, this is why I'm asking hundreds and even thousands of people on all of our Cross Church campuses today to formulate an army of warriors of prayer. And I'm going to ask you today to become a part of the Cross Church Circle, because the times are desperate and we, the church, must rise until the church becomes a testimony.
It's Carpet One's 25th anniversary sale, and we're celebrating by giving you amazing savings. Take up to 50% off all flooring store-wide. Carpet, hardwood, laminate, tile, vinyl, and more. Buy it all with no interest for 3 years. Plus, get up to $500 cash back with manufacturer's instant rebates. Thank you, Northwest Arkansas, for allowing us to serve you for the last 25 years. Come celebrate and save now during Carpet One's 25th anniversary sale.
I'm Ronnie Floyd of Cross Church, and I want to personally invite you to join us this Sunday. At our church, we believe God's Word changes lives. You see, we believe that when you come to our church, you will find love and community. And we believe that you will find a fellowship that is exciting, but yet compassionate. We hope that you will visit at crosschurch.com and discover a Cross Church campus near you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're back here on the Josh Floyd Show, where we're talking about our playoff game this coming Friday night against Wynne. Now, Coach, we'll be down at Wynne, Arkansas. Boy, that is a travel. That is way down there. We're talking about 4.5 hours, sure. 5 hours. So how are you guys going to handle that travel trip?
I don't know. It's a long way. We obviously haven't traveled that far all year. But, hey, we're excited to be in the playoffs. And at this point in the season, it's like we told our guys Saturday, it really doesn't matter if you're a 1 seed or 4 seed or conference champion. I mean, at this point, everybody's 0-0, and you've got as good a chance as anybody is to advance. And we're obviously, I mean, you take it one game at a time. The whole season's on the line this Friday night, and that's what makes it exciting. If we have to drive 4 hours or 6 hours or 8 hours, we would do it to be able to keep playing.
Well, that's a great point. You know, everybody's 0-0 going into the playoff season. Now, you've got the 2 seed Wynne from the East versus the 3 seed Shiloh Saints from the West. We're traveling down there to play them. They play a spread offense. Tell me what you're looking for as you prepare for Wynne.
Sure. Well, they've got some really good athletes. It starts with their running back. They've got a kid that can run. He's only a sophomore, but he's a really, really good football player. And I think he was a guy really going into the season they weren't expecting much out of. And then he's just really come on. It rushed for a lot of yards that they will spread out. They've got a really good quarterback and same kind of kid that can – he's a good player with his feet, you know, makes a lot of plays with his feet, keeps plays alive, on pass plays. And so they're definitely scary because they can score and they can move the football. Defensively, they've got some really good players, just some speed. And, we don't see as much speed at times at this area of the state. And they've got a lot of speed over there. Everybody in that conference seems like has really good athletes. And so, I think it's going to take us a little bit of time Friday night to adjust to that speed, but I know our guys are going to be ready and they're fired up and excited to be in the playoffs and hopefully we can make a run.
Well, let's talk about some of those players that we saw a little bit of on Friday night, specifically John Marcus Carruthers. coming up, a freshman player, got a lot of talent there, looked really nice there towards the end of the fourth quarter, you know. He had some good runs. Are you going to move some of those players up as we look at this game coming into Wynne, because we've been depleted a little bit?
Sure, yeah, we will, and we always move those guys up anyway. And so John Marcus is a guy that's going to be a real good football player for us one day, and he came in there on a Friday night and had some good runs. We've got some other guys that we'll probably sprinkle in on special teams along the way, because we do have a good group that's coming up of ninth graders, and you know, we think they can help us make this run.
So let's talk about some players that maybe are getting a little healthier. Are we going to be able to see Kyle Plunkett maybe next week?
We don't know for sure yet. You know, Kyle's a guy that's it's turned into a week-to-week thing with his knee, and hopefully it's healing better, and he's actually got a doctor's appointment early this week, and so we'd obviously love to have him. You know, it'd be great to have a few of those guys back.
Well, I tell you what, Dylan Sharp's been playing well. You know, he just had some things going against him on Friday night. Looks like I know you'll have the team prepared. What are you most looking forward to in this first playoff game as you prepare for Wynne?
Well, I think we've just got to get back to why we were successful the 5 weeks before. And that's the thing we've talked about with our team was we didn't do the things Friday night that we've been doing all year. You know, we had guys going the wrong way at times on offense and guys messing up, you know, just assignment wise. And that's not good football, and blame that on me. I'm the coach, whatever you want to blame it on. We didn't get it done Friday night. And so I think we have to get back to where we were. You know, we won five games in a row by playing good, solid, fundamentally sound football, and we've got to get back to that, and I think that'll give us a chance.
Well, Coach, great conference season this past season as we looked forward to the playoffs. I tell you what, coming from the season we had last year in the 5A West to where we have this year, you can definitely see progress in the Shiloh Saints as they were just a game short of shearing for that 5A West Conference Championship. For Eric Vaughan, voice of the Shiloh Saints, along with Coach Floyd here, we want to thank you for watching the Josh Floyd Show all year long. Hopefully we've got a couple, three more shows in us as we've started this playoff season. We'll be rooting for the Saints over Wynne this past Friday night. Long travel time, if you can make it, we'd love to have you down at Wynne for the game this Friday night, 7:00 start there in Wynne. If not, be sure and catch us on shilohchristianfootball.com, where you can see all the Shiloh action every Friday night. Well, Coach, want to say thank you for the show so far. Hopefully we got a couple, three more left in us. And fans, we thank you for watching the Josh Floyd Show, and we'll see you next week when we talk about, hopefully, a big victory over Wynne in the first round of the playoffs. Thank you for watching, everyone.